Hey there. In our previous videos, we introduced the high-power stereo Bluetooth amplifier based on TPA3255 and demonstrated its driving capability by burning an electric stove. But that's not all. In this video, we're going to show you how to integrate the BDM9 into your audio system step by step. As you know, audio source, amplifier, speaker, and power supply are essential parts of any audio system. With its built-in Bluetooth module, the BDM9 supports wireless audio connection, making it a versatile addition to your setup. We'll guide you through the other connections you need to make and show you how to connect to your audio source. Don't miss out on this informative video, let's get started. To get started, let's connect your speakers to the BDM9. The BDM9 features speaker output connectors that use industrial-grade mini-fit plug-in terminals, making it incredibly easy and convenient to connect your cables correspondingly. In addition to the speaker output, the BDM9 also provides I2S and analog signal output. These outputs can be used for monitoring or delivering to another amplifier board to build an audio 2.1 or 4.0 system. Now, let's connect external potentiometers for separate treble, bass, and volume control. With these functions, taking control of your audio system has never been easier. The BDM9 also comes equipped with external power supply and Bluetooth indicators, making it easy to know the running status of your audio system. You'll never have to worry about whether everything is working properly or not. The BDM9 also features PC UI control, which we'll be demonstrating in future videos. Stay tuned for that. Now, let's move on to audio input. If you want Bluetooth input, simply set S101 to BT_LBT_R and keep the jumpers of J103 inserted. It's that easy. Once you've connected the BDM9 to a 36-volt power supply and turned it on, you'll see the Bluetooth LED blink. This means that Bluetooth is ready for pairing. Once Bluetooth is connected successfully, the LED will turn on constantly, indicating that it's ready to play music. Furthermore, when S101 is set to BT_LBT_R, the BDM9 supports line input, which has a switching relationship with Bluetooth input. To switch to line input, simply take off the jumper and plug in your line input cable. However, we highly recommend keeping the jumper for future use. When you want to switch back to Bluetooth input, insert the jumper to position 3 and 4. The BDM9 also provides a bypass line input port, which delivers the signal directly to the amplifier chip without passing through the Bluetooth module. This results in higher audio quality. Please note that treble, bass, and volume controls are not available in this mode. You can get the BDM9 for only $35.10 on our AliExpress shop, so why wait? Get yours today. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking it, sharing it, and leaving a comment to let us know your thoughts. Thank you for watching.